Hi everybody, welcome in. My name is Ernest and I'm gonna teach you how to cook. Today we're going around the world again and we're doing some Thai food and some Asian food. It's just one of my favorite kinds of food. It really is, other than Tex-Mex. Today we're making red beef curry. Ooh, it is so good. Beef red curry has this wonderful flank steak in it. Just stay tuned, it's gonna be delicious. And in the extra helping, we're having one of those today. It's a really simple dish you can make for dinner at any time. It's egg drop soup. It's really great to take for lunches. It reheats really well. So delicious. You don't wanna miss it. Let's get going. This is Eating in Bed. To admit, I'm a little bit of a latecomer when it comes to curry. My friends had always said, Ernest, you have to try curry. It's so good. It's the best thing in the world. And I'm like, okay, calm yourself. Eventually, when we moved here, a Thai place opened up less than a half a mile from the house. Celadon Thai, right up here on Route 2. And I thought, let's go try it. So everybody said, try yellow curry, try the red curry. And I'm like, okay. And I did. And holy smokes, where has this been all of my life? It was one of the most wonderful things I'd ever eaten. Now, recently on the show, we did curry chicken and rice, which is kind of different. You kind of braised it in a pan, you cooked it all together. But today, I'm making red beef curry. I mean, it can be red beef, or it's actually red curry with beef, but I was trying to make it shorter. And it's really, really simple. And I'm gonna explain to you what we're doing as we go. It's a quick recipe. You put it over a little rice, just eat it straight on. You don't want to miss it. So let's get going here. This in my pan is you can't see it because it's a little clear, but it's a teaspoon and a half to 2 teaspoons of coconut oil. You don't have to use coconut oil. Since we're doing curry, I'm like, okay, well, let's just use some coconut oil. But you really want to use something flavorless. So a nice vegetable oil is kind of what you want here. So I've got this over a medium-high heat and I'm just letting it melt down. It's really clear. You can't see it. What we're going to start with is curry paste. Now they make green curry paste and red curry paste, and you can find it in the stores. It usually comes in a little bottle like this because it's pretty strong stuff and you don't use much at any given time. This is a really popular brand of it. If you have an Asian market in your area, definitely go there and find some good curry paste to work with. This will last you a while depending how much you make curry. But this is red curry paste. It's just made with some red chili peppers, some garlic. It's got some lemongrass in it. It's a strong peppery, it's almost like a really spicy bean dip in a way. It's got that idea to it. But what I'm gonna do here is, this is heated up. I'm gonna put 2 tablespoons or so. I don't wanna bang on the pan because it's porcelain and enamel. You're gonna put 2 teaspoons, not tablespoons, sorry, about 2 teaspoons of curry paste right into the oil because you wanna cook this down and get it going. I know that doesn't seem like very much, but trust me, you don't need very much for this recipe. So just with a whisk, you're gonna get that rolling around in there a little bit just till it starts to break up. Keep your heat a little lower. You don't wanna go too high on the heat. Look at that, it's already got some great color coming out. Look at that. It's jumping around in there and you really don't wanna cook it for more than 30 seconds. Treat it like garlic. You wanna work pretty quickly with that. Now you're going to whisk in 3/4 cup of coconut milk. A lot of people use light coconut milk, but I say, listen, if you're making curry, go for the big tabbouleh and the big kahunas and get full on coconut milk. So 3/4 cup there, just whisk that in. Also fish sauce. You can find fish sauce on the Asian aisle. You don't need very much of it. You use it as a seasoning agent. Let me pull this down because it's bubbling. And you only need 1 tablespoon of that, which I have right here, which you may not be able to see because of the steam. But 1 tablespoon of fish sauce goes right in here. And also 2 teaspoons of brown sugar. You can use light or dark. I think what I had today was dark brown sugar. So you're gonna work that in there, stir that together, whisk it together. The smell is already fantastic with the coconut milk and that curry. It smells delightful today. Now I'm using a 12-inch skillet. That's kind of what you wanna use. You wanna be able to spread this out a little bit. 10-inch you could probably get away with, but shoot for an 11 or 12 inch if you have. This is my Lodge 11 inch casserole dish that I can use on the stovetop or in the oven. Now I'm gonna keep this over medium heat and I'm gonna bring it to a simmer and whisk it frequently. What's gonna happen is this is going to thicken up a little bit. Your coconut milk is gonna cook down ever so slightly and this is gonna thicken up and then we're gonna add some more stuff to it. Okay, so it's been about 4 or 5 minutes. This sauce really thickens up. And what I love about using an enamel pan like this that's coated, see how just none of this is sticking? I mean, that is just so cool to me. What I have is flank steak. You need about 3/4 of a pound of flank steak. And I've cut this into small cubes. You can see the grain in flank steak. So what you're gonna do with that is cut it with the grain in 2-inch strips. So you're gonna have long, thick 2-inch strips. Once you get those strips cut with the grain, cut across the grain, cut each strip, you know, going this way, cut each strip across in about 1/8 of an inch to 1/4 inch pieces like I have here. This is about 3/4 of a pound. And this is a lot of steak cut into little pieces. You can see where it's 2 inches wide and then about 1/8 of an inch thick. So this has thickened up. This will really cook down. You're reducing it a little bit, actually, is what you're doing. And then you're gonna put this steak right in there. Oh, it's already starting to look good, isn't it? And you're gonna keep this at a simmer and cook it in this sauce for about another 5 minutes or so. It'll cook, it'll take a little bit. You can already see right here, this piece is already starting to cook. So just make sure it stays, you know, all in one layer. Keep tossing it around. It's gonna get nice and thick and delicious. It's not gonna be real runny or anything like that. If you can't find flank steak in the regular section of your grocery store where things are already wrapped, go to the butcher counter. More likely than not, they're going to have that meat in the butcher counter and you can have them cut exactly what you need. You can see now that this meat is already starting to cook up. I'm gonna keep turning it regularly. You don't want anything to stick or, you know, harden up in here or anything. Let this cook for about 4 or 5 minutes, just until the meat is done. When we come back, we're gonna add a few vegetables to this. Okay, so it's been about 4 minutes or so. You know, normally I use a wooden spoon, but this time I'm actually using a spatula because a lot of this can kind of splatter up on the sides and you want all the flavor in the pan. So I've been using this to scrape around the perimeter of my pan here. Now you just need a couple more things and we're gonna let this cook for a little bit on its own. First, you need a small bell pepper. Cut it into long, thin strips. If this was a really tall bell pepper. Actually, it was about 2 of these pieces. Let me show you, this pepper was about this long. It was a really big pepper. So I ribbed it and seeded it and cut it in half and then made these little strip pieces in there. So you just want a small bell pepper. I'm gonna add about half of what I have here, not too much. Maybe a little bit more than half, maybe 2/3 or so. And then you need 1/4 pound of sugar snap peas. Now sugar snap peas are these wonderful peas. They have they look like beans and they're a little puffy on the inside and you wanna remove the strings. Let me show you how to remove the string. If you grab the top, you can see where the thinner end is right here, that's the bottom. Grab the top with your fingernail and just pull. And you see how that comes out of there? See that little string that comes out right there? That's what you wanna get rid of. Let me show you one more time. Here's the pea. This tapered in right here, sometimes it's a little wider. That's the bottom. It's easier to grab from the top with your fingernail on your thumbnail and then just pull that string off of it right there. It won't open up or anything. Right at the top. Sometimes they don't have much of a string. Sometimes they'll go all the way down to the bottom. These have already been stringed. So I'm gonna put those right in there. 1/4 of a cup. And get those in there, toss them in. Oh, doesn't that look delightful? Come on. Now I'm gonna bring this down to a nice simmer and cover it. Let it cook for about another 5 minutes. You want those vegetables to cook, but not be mushy. They should be tender, but still have that little bit of resistance right in the middle, almost like an al dente pasta, where it's soft on the outside, but it's still a little bit firm, yet still edible on the inside. You don't want them super mushy or anything. You can leave it open skillet like this, but I like to pull the heat down a little bit because the heat's gonna build up in here. Pull the heat down and then put the lid on it for about 5 minutes. Check it about halfway through. Make sure everything is moving along fine, and then we're gonna finish it up. All right, we're gonna take a break. Stay tuned, because in the extra helping, I'm gonna show you how to make that egg drop soup. I'm telling you, I can't express how important homemade chicken stock is for this. And you can try beef stock, vegetable stock if you're vegetarian or vegan. You can do fish stock or pork stock. You can really kind of change up that recipe any way you want to. And don't be afraid to experiment with different vegetables in there. But I'm showing you a base recipe. It's got snow peas in it, some mung bean sprouts, and a whole lot of yum. And egg, of course. Super easy, comes across in no time. It's really great, it travels really well. You can take it to work the next day and impress everybody that you made your own egg drop soup. It looks much different than that yellow gunky stuff you get in takeout. Stay tuned, we're gonna do egg drop soup. When we come back, it's gonna be about 5 minutes later, and this curry is gonna be done and we're gonna eat it, cause it's good. I'll see you right after this.
Moist, wet, wonderful colors. Colors that lick your lips. Moisture Whip Colors by Maybelline, with moisturizers and a protective sunscreen to keep your lips very soft, very moist, very wet. And I think that's very wonderful.
Moisture Whip Lipstick by Maybelline, for long-lasting colors that lick your lips.
First, start with 8 ounces of snow peas. You can use sugar snap peas if you want to. Stack some of the peas together and cut the tips off of them. They're very sharp and not very edible. Cut the ends off both sides. Then cut the peas into 1-inch pieces. Next, in a large pot over medium-high heat, add 3.5 cups of chicken stock, homemade is best, and 3 cups of water. 4 teaspoons of fresh ginger, peeled and then finely grated or minced, and 4 teaspoons of soy sauce. Whisk that together and bring it to a boil over high heat. Once it starts to boil, add the snow peas and 1.5 cups of mung bean sprouts. Those are the larger, thicker ones like you would find in a bowl of pho. Stir that together and bring it back to a boil. Next, you're gonna need 3 whole extra large eggs. Beat the eggs until they're combined. Now use your fork and stir in one direction in the pot. Slowly drizzle the eggs into it. Don't pour it all at once. As you stir and pour the eggs in, they'll get nice and feathery and break apart. Turn the heat off at this point. Add 1/2 teaspoon of rice vinegar and 1/2 teaspoon of toasted sesame oil. These are the flavorings for the soup and they are strong, so don't use a lot. Now you just serve it up. You can add some chopped green onions on top or a few sprigs of cilantro. It's a delicious, quick dish for dinner. That is egg drop soup. Enjoy.
So at this point, you really want to season it with some salt because we really haven't put a lot of salt in there. So I'm gonna do about 1/2 teaspoon here. Toss it together. I've turned the heat off. I tested the vegetables about 3 minutes in and realized I only had to go about 1.5 minutes. So you really don't have to go very long on this. Toss that in. Ooh, doesn't that just look beautiful? That's red beef curry. Just delicious. It's not too soupy. The meat is nice and tender. I'm making sure all that salt is incorporated and everything's nice and coated. Those beans are still going to have, the snow peas, I'm sorry, I keep saying beans. The snow peas are going to have a little bit of a bite to them, but they're going to be crunchy yet soft at the same time. So I'm going to try a little bit on a plate here. I'm just going to try a little bit. You usually want to cook this with some rice. Make a nice big pot of rice with this. Serve it over that, and you can't go wrong there. Oh, come on. Pepper's trying to get away from me, so I'll go for this one. Now normally when you season or you top this, you'd use a little bit of green onion. What's really popular in Asian culture that people don't think about is basil. So some fresh basil and even a squeeze of lime juice. If you've ever had pho, you get all of these things with your meal. And you could even put some bean sprouts in this if you wanted to. Now I'm not going to top it here, but you'd put this in a nice over a bed of rice and put all this on there and, you know, flavor it up and top it the way you want. But let's try, I got to try the meat first. I got to get a little sauce on it. It's so good. That meat is so good. Flank steak is nice the way it cooks. It's still kind of, it's tender, but it still has a good body to it for something like this. Let me get the pepper and a snap pea. Mmm, perfect. Those vegetables are perfect. So that's curry. I really encourage you to change up the vegetables or the kind of meat that you use in it. Try the green curry paste, that's really good. You would think that it's really intense because that curry paste has a really intense smell, but you're using a very small amount of it, you're cooking off the harshness, and then you're adding that coconut milk to it. It is such a winning combination. So give the video a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments, what's your favorite kind of curry? Have you tried curry? Surely you have. Let me know what your favorite curry is. I would love to hear about it. Click subscribe so you don't miss any videos. I'm gonna go have some of this, make myself some rice. I'm tongue twisted, I just want it so bad. I appreciate you watching. I hope you try this. It is so good, so flavorful, and really good. There's nothing that fattening in it, really. Get a good lean cut of meat, you're good to go. Thanks for watching, I'll see you next time. Bye.